supermarket? I don't think so. And what supermarket lets you win a car for shopping there? And then
throws in another car for good measure. Do people have a good time shopping here? Well, I'll tell you. When you reach into a shelf and pull out $5,000, you're having a great time. This supermarket has already given away over $2 million, and they're ready to give away more. What supermarket are we talking about? Supermarket Sweet. So today, who's got the McCormick meatloaf back in season? Lisa and Tina. Okay, you're off. Who's got the Regina white wine vinegar? Heather and Ann. Okay, you're off. Irish Spring Soap, John and Andrea. Okay, and you're on. We're ready to play Supermarket Sweep. And here's the host of our show, David Rufrank.
Thank you, and welcome to Supermarket Sweep. Yep, we have given away over $2 million. So what do you say? Let's go for $3 million. All right, here's your free minute and a half to use in the big sweep right there. There it is. All right, now we're going to play our mini sweep. One of you can pick up 10 seconds in a cash bonus. So get your hands on your buzzers. About chewing gum with sugar, your dentist was strident. So he gave you some samples. Andrea?
Trident?
Of sugar-free Trident. Very good, Andrea. That's 10 seconds for your team. Let's see if John can pick up the $50 for your team by finding the specially marked Trident and getting it back to me within 30 seconds. 20 seconds or less is worth 100. And go, John. Go. There. Well, don't worry, that 10 seconds is going to come in real handy during the sweep. Okay, relax for a second, John. We'll meet our other players. Tina, tell us how you know Lisa.
She is my sister.
And what do you do, Lisa?
I'm a full-time homemaker. I have three children, and I homeschool my five-year-old.
Right. And how about you, Tina?
I'm an administrative assistant for an insurance company.
And you guys came up from San Diego?
Yes.
Thank you for that. All right. Ann, tell us how you know Heather.
Heather dates my son.
Oh, that's an interesting coupling. Heather, what do you do, ma'am?
I'm an accounting manager for a major property management corporation.
Ooh, good, that's a mouthful. And Ann, how about you?
I'm an operations manager for an insurance company.
Well, now, what made you come on the show with your son's girlfriend?
She's a lot of fun.
Oh, which is why he's dating her, I'm sure.
Yeah.
All right, Andrea, tell us how you know John.
He is my boyfriend of 4 years.
And what do you do, John?
I'm a video game tester.
Man, that's every guy's fantasy.
That's right.
Cool. All right, Andrea, what do you do?
I'm an administrative assistant by day and aspiring musician at night.
All right, you guys ready to play the game? I think we should press on then. Let's give our first players a chance to pick up some extra seconds. So that means Tina, Heather, and John. We'll see you guys in just a little bit. Now I want to see if you three have a good sense of value, okay? So look at this item right off of our shelves. It is a 22-ounce bottle of spray and wash laundry stain remover. Now, today we put a price of $2.49 on it. Do you think that price is too high, too low, or just right? Lock in your answers now. One for too high, two for too low, and three for just right. Get it right? 10 seconds. All three of you nail it? 30 seconds. What'd you say, Lisa?
I said that it's too low.
You thought our price was too low, okay? How about you, Ann?
I said too low.
You also thought it was too low. Andrea?
Make the three. I chose too low.
Everybody thought we were too low. Well, let's see. The actual price of the stain remover turned out to be $3.29. And the correct answer is two. We were too low. So Lisa gets 30 seconds, Ann gets 30 seconds, and Andrea gets 30 seconds. Great way to start. Stay with us. When we come back, even more games, even more chances for our players to build up their sweep time. Welcome back to Supermarket Sweep, and let's say hello again to Tina, Heather, and John. Okay, here we go. I'm about to show you the name of an item. I'm only going to reveal its first letter and its last letter. Then I'll give you three clues about it. Get ready to jump in and tell me what it is. Hands on your buzzers. This word begins with P and ends with A. Red. Hungarian. Spice. Heather.
Paprika.
That's it. That is it. Now this word begins with M and ends with E. Egg whites. Cream of tartar. Pie topping. Tina.
Mousse?
Nope. Heather.
Meringue.
That's it. This word begins with B and ends with A. Italian appetizer. Olive oil. John.
Bruschetta.
Let's see. You sure did get it. Now this next word begins with L and ends with E. Extract. Anise flavor. Black or red. John.
Licorice.
See. Yes, all right. Here's the last one. Word begins with E and ends with A. Filled. Rolled. Mexican cuisine. Heather.
Enchilada.
Enchilada is what we're looking for. Okay, now we're going to play Animal Sounds, and you guys are going to be the animals. So step on over here to Farmer Dave's barnyard right here. And these are the friends we brought with us today. We have the lamb, and we have the chicken, and we have the pig. So I want to see how you guys' animal sounds are. Heather, can you give us your best lamb, please? Yeah, it's a good lamb. It's a quiet lamb, but yes, all right. And John, how about your chicken? Oh, now there's a chicken. A chicken you can be proud of. And Tina, how's your pig?
Oink, oink, oink.
That's a good pig. All right, good. Now, I'm going to read a statement regarding one of these animals. When I do, buzz in, and when I call your name, you give the animal sound that represents the correct answer. Now, if you think it's none of these, you make this sound. Can you guys do that? Tina? Oh, yeah. Okay, there you go. Here we go. Here we go. A lot of these animals have become famous through TV and movies. Babe is one example. John.
Oink, 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 oink.
Oink, oink, it is a pig. All right. Babe the talking pig. This animal is the basis for the German delicacy, Hasenpfeffer. Heather. Nope. John. No. Tina.
Oink, 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 oink.
No. It's the... Hasenpfeffer is German. It's a rabbit. It's a rabbit. Okay, hands on your buzzers. Here's the next one. You all gave it a great shot, though, and I love your sound. A famous Ivy League song tells about this poor little animal who's gone astray. Heather. Poor little lamb who's gone astray. Ba, ba, ba. Here's the last one. A lot of people say snake, alligator, and other exotic foods. Heather. Tastes just like chicken. Very nice. Let's see where we are. Tina's team with 2 minutes. Heather's with 250. John's with 240. Time for the round robin game. Partners, come on up here. Hey, guess what? We're going to play Scramble Letters. So as you know, this is your last chance to pick up some extra seconds. Every correct answer is worth 10 seconds. Six of these, 60 seconds are up for grabs. Hands on your buzzers. Here's the first one. Japanese. John.
Karaoke.
Let's see. Okay, change places. Here's the next one. Bulb. Oven baked. Strong aroma. Bulb. Andrea.
Roasted garlic.
That's it. Okay, switch. John and Andrea just moved into the lead. Here's the next one. Pungent. Vegetable. Mince. John.
Onion bits.
That's it. Okay, switch. And the next one. Unique. First. Recipe. Unique. First recipe. Original. Okay, change places. Here's the next one. Tangy. Hot. And Tina.
Thickens.
John.
Thick and spicy.
That's it. Okay, change. Here's the last one. From bees. Condiment. Lisa.
Honey mustard.
That's it. All right. So, who's going to run the big sweep? Who's going to run for it? Who's going to run? Lisa, Heather, and John. Don't go away now. When you come back, you will see Lisa, Heather, and John running wild through our aisles. They have a chance to win $5,000 right here on Supermarket Sweep. Minutes and 20 seconds, you'll start first. Heather and Ann, you have 2 minutes and 50 seconds. Lisa and Tina, you have 2 minutes and 10 seconds. All right, take a look out there in our supermarket. Everything is up for grabs. Fill as many carts as you can. Listen carefully. These are our special big money makers we have for you in the big sweep today, okay? Our biggest money maker is the alphabet game. The letters are D, E, and F. So I want you to bring back D, Dawn dish liquid, E, Energizer batteries, and F, Finesse shampoo. Now, do not put those products into your regular cart. Instead, they have to go to these mini baskets that are attached to the front of your cart. Now, it's fine to use more than one mini basket, but the Dawn dish liquid, Energizer batteries, and Finesse shampoo must be in the mini baskets before the bell rings, and remember, only one of each item. You do that, we'll add $300 to your total. Also, spread throughout the market are 3 bags filled with empty cans. Now, each runner may retrieve 1 bag, race it back to their table, then the partner must stack all 21 cans in the shape of a pyramid, just like these, before the sweep is over. And remember, you have to use every can. Now, if the partner gets the stack job done, you'll get a marker like this, and that is good for $150. Also, bring back the amount of candy we need, and that's going to be worth $200. And don't forget our bonus specials worth up to $250. And of course, the team whose runner sweeps up the most money in merchandise and bonus prizes wins the game and the right to go for $5,000 in game. Okay, runners, get ready. The clock is set at 3 minutes and 20 seconds. That's when John will take off. On your mark, get set, and go, John. Go, go.
John of T1 is a strong man with a lot of speed, so where will he start first? He's putting his 30-second lead to good use, whipping in cuts of beef as if each was light as a feather. Hey, Heather of Team 2 is getting ready. Now John's mining our gold-wrapped hams for a fast limit of 5. Next on his list, hey, this guy is clearly no turkey when it comes to loading in big birds for big bucks in a hurry. But look out, it's time to see how he handles competition.
1 and go!
Go!
Let's see how well Heather of Team 2 plays the game of catch-up. Yeah, she's in our expensive baby care section. John picked up a bonus and a bag of soda cans. Keep a sharp eye out for shoppers playing the alphabet game. And that's just what Heather is up to. She's looking for the finesse. Sometimes it takes a little finesse to find it under pressure. And, hey, she got it. Good for the letter F. And it goes in her special mini basket. Do you see it? Look at John. Now he's scanning the beauty products for the finesse. And while Heather is picking off health products behind him, John is still hunting for the finesse. And he got it. Now 2 shoppers have the letter F. This sweep is almost complete. Lisa's been pent up for a long time, and now that David's unleashed her fighting spirit, let's follow this young lady, see what she does for Team 3. Looks like she wants a bag of soda cans. But, whoa, hey, Heather snatched that one first. So Lisa scoops up a 3rd one. Now she takes aim at a bonus, our Oscar Mayer Franks. And to be frank, I'm exhausted just watching. Back to John, he picks off the Energizer batteries, letter E on the alphabet list for his 2nd item. What does Heather have in mind next? She was watching John, I guess, because she gets the Energizer batteries now. She and John each have just 1 more item to go. And in fact, I can see John about to complete his shopping list. John gets the Dawn dishwashing liquid, and that adds a big $300 to Team 1 score. Now he wants liquid plumber. He must be feeling a little drained by now. Let's check in on Lisa. She's moving into the beauty section. And you know, she's looking for the finesse. Her 1st item on the alphabet list. But where is it? It's here somewhere. She looks up and gets it. Good. Letter F for Team 3. 1 down, 2 to go. Meanwhile, the action's heating up at the stack table. Team 1 tops off her pyramid. There. Good for $150. Team 3's pyramid's underway. Soon we might see a 3rd stack job. Well, back to Heather. She's cleaning up with Pledge Granite sweeper cloths, and that's not the only thing she's looking for in this aisle. She's after the Dawn liquid, and yes, she completes the alphabet list for team two. John's in the deli section, and while he loads in gourmet ham, I want to show you the action one more time at the snack table. Look at this. Team two might build today's third perfect pyramid. And whoa! Oh no! Wow, we're in our final seconds. Lisa got the Energizer batteries for today's third complete alphabet list. And I'm completely out of energy describing this week.
Okay, that's it, everybody. Come on back. Thanks, Randy. All right, the official checkers are standing by. Just a little bit, we'll find out which team has the highest total, which team is going for that $5,000 in cash. It's sitting out there waiting for them, so don't go away. Welcome back to Supermarket Sweep. Okay, our checkers have entered all of this merchandise in the registers. Let's hit those total buttons and find out who won the big sweep, who's going for $5,000. Okay, Lisa and Tina, you got everything I wanted in the alphabet game. That's $300. You got the shack job completed. That's $150. You also have a bonus. Let's see how much your Oscar Mayer Franks are. Worth, they are worth a super bonus. $250. Now we add that to all your groceries, it gives you a grand total today of $858. All right, Heather and Ann, you also got the alphabet game completed. On top of that, that's $300. We add that to all your groceries, it gives you a grand total today of $1,215. Puts Heather and Ann in the lead. Okay, John and Andrea, you also got the alphabet game done. That's $300. You also got the stack job done. That's $150. And you got a bonus. Let's see how much those premium crackers are worth. They are worth $50. Now, we add that to all your groceries. If your grand total is higher than $1,215, you're going to be looking for $5,000. If not, Heather and Ann will. Let's see, your grand total with your groceries is $1,455. John and Andy, a new win. Thank you all for playing. We have some great gifts for you. Come on. All right, guys. Now, let's add $5,000 to that, huh? Really, there's nothing to it. Okay, you've got a whole minute to do it. Three clues to help you out. Your hands do, however, have to be on that money before the final bell. So before we started, you chose envelope number one. This is your first clue. You guys ready to go?
Yes, sir.
As soon as I finish reading this, the countdown starts. Good luck. She said, 8-hour lipstick, I'll give it a whirl. It's from Easy Breezy Beautiful. Go, go, go.
Cartoon characters.
Dennis.
And combine it with the opposite of daughters.
Sons. Dennisons.
What's Dennisons?
Turkey. Dennisons. Meat. Look at deli. Okay, look. Keep your eyes open. Keep your eyes open. Dennisons. Dennisons. Meat. Meat. I can see it. Dennisons. Yeah, frozen. Let's look frozen. Okay.
Let me see if I can help out. Come on over here, Andrea. Let's see here. Take the first name of the cartoon character who is a menace, Dennis, and combine it with the opposite of daughters. Denison's chili. Denison's chili.
Okay.
All right, but listen, you had a great sweep. This is $200. We add it all together, gives you a grand total today of $1,655. Congratulations. And this is David Ruprecht saying goodbye from Supermarket Sweep. Listen, the next time you're at a checkout stand and you hear the beep, think of all the fun you could have on Supermarket Sweep. You didn't know that it was- Kelly. Oh, come on. Jim will show us where it is. Dennis is chilly. Trust me, I know that. I'm not being superior at all.
Once he said it, like, that's exactly
yeah,
what
that's it
is.
That's it. Oh, no, this is a lot easier when I'm sitting over there. There it is.
Okay.
There it is.
For Supermarket Sweep. Supermarket Sweep has been an Al Howard production.